Welcome to our tutorial on how we're going to create a simple calligraphy logo for our golf estate. In this video, we're going to be using a basic calligraphy font as inspired by these famous logos that were created with calligraphy. We're going to jump right in and convert it to Photopea using our famous Photopea tool. Going to access www.canva.com and you're going to open a blank logo canvas. Once the canvas is open, you're going to press your forward slash so that you open the magic menu. You're always welcome to press T for text or use your menu on the design section. So, and you're going to click on text to add text to your page. We're going to increase the size of the text, then we're going to type the name of the business that we're designing for. Then we're going to go to our fonts and we're going to be searching for calligraphy. So on the menu of the different kinds of fonts that are available, we're going to scroll through and look for calligraphy. Calligraphy is a visual art related to writing. And if you pick that font, it looks like a handwritten and it looks quite sexy and cool. You're going to scroll through until you pick the one that you want. The one that I loved and it is free is called Pinyon Script. So you're going to select the Pinyon Script font and then you have that beautiful looking calligraphy logo that is simple but sophisticated. So I'm going to increase the size and make it 340 so it is nice and big. Then I'm going to press T for text again to add the rest of the name of the business. And for this one, I'm going to change the font so that it goes hand in hand with the calligraphy that we've added. I'm going to select Hatton, but I want the thin Hatton font. And I'm going to make this capital letter, state, and then I'm going to size the letters and space them nice and even. Next, I'm going to just align everything so that it is spot on. Then I'm going to change color. I use a beautiful website called Coolors that gives you different, beautiful, different colors that match. So I use this website a lot. I'm going to link it in the description for you below. And then I'm going to copy the hex code and then go back to my design and then change the color to that one that I want to use. And it starts looking amazeballs. And then I'm going to change the color for the bottoms and I'm going to change it like that. We're almost done with our logo. I do like creating a signature look on logos because they always need to stand out for our customer. It is a design choice that I want to make. So when you see on these little points here, I'm going to add a different color just to have that nice design feel. However, it does look gorgeous in my opinion. I'm going to press C for circle and I'm going to zoom in and make a small circle and then move it over to that point that I was talking about there. Like that. When I zoom out, my logo is done. I'm ready to jump in on Photopea. Then I'm going to press on share, scroll down to download, select transparent background, and then download the second one that we just did together. And I'm going to click done and I'm going to click download. If you don't have Canva Pro, then you're welcome to trial it using my link on the description below. However, if you don't have a budget at the moment, you're welcome to use remove.bg or erase.bg. Next, we're going to access www.photopea.com and we're going to be converting it or adding it to a building so that it gives that nice effect when we're presenting it to our customer. Then I'm going to select PSD templates and my templates are here. I'm going to scroll down because it's an estate, it's a building. I'm going to scroll until I find this building one that I loved. I'm going to click on building so that it opens up and I'm going to open it on the link. Once it has loaded, I'm going to move to the right hand side and I'm going to place my logo where it says your logo here. So I'm going to double click on the checkout box so that it opens up the section where I can place my logo. And I'm going to hide the example that the designer has given me. I will click and drag my design that we've just done together and I'm going to just size it and make it a little bit big and then align it until I see the red lines, and then I'm gonna click the correct mark and press Ctrl S to change it to Smart Object. And then once it's done, I'm gonna click on the first tab that says Building Business, and then voila, my logo is added on the building and it looks amazing. However, I do want the colors to match the logo. The template does allow us to do that. So I'm gonna double click where it says plate color change. I'm gonna double click on there, and then I can add my hex code over there. And then I can paste the hex code and click OK. And then the color matches and it looks absolutely stunning. We do have a Canva course dedicated to designers on our website, learnwithzad.com. Thank you so much for joining me on this tutorial. I will see you on the next video.